Hi everyone, welcome to Video Lectures, an ISR initiative, Shivananda Sharma Memorial RV College. SSMRV College is one of the premier institutes run by the prestigious RV group of institutions, and it has come up with a unique initiative to engage students at the time of this unforeseen medical emergency caused by corona outbreak. As a socially responsible institution, we would like to connect academically with students to make good the losses caused. In this connection, I, Pallavi of Department BBA, is posting a video on the subject marketing management, and the topic is services marketing. Please watch the video till the end and like, share with your peer groups and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you. So let's start with the chapter. Firstly, let's understand what is services. So all of you know what is a service, right? Going, taking the service from the teacher, lawyer, doctor, and a postman delivering the letters, you going to a restaurant and the restaurant is serving you food. All these are services, you know. I'm just giving you some examples. You going to, saloon to take services which are provided in the saloon is also a service. So I'll read out the meaning for you. Services is a type of economic activity that is intangible and is not stored and does not result in ownership. Obviously, you will not own anything here. You will just enjoy the service provided by the service providers, right? Service is consumed at a point of sale. Exactly. And at that time, you have to, take the service. You can't go home or later take the service. Yes or no? So, service is something which is consumed at a point of sale, okay, then and there. And services are one of the two key components of economics, the other being goods. You all know what is goods as well. We will study about the differences in the upcoming slides. Now, let's discuss the definition of services. According to Kotler, any activity or benefit that one party can offer to another that is essentially intangible and does not result in the ownership of anything is called service. Guys, I told you that service cannot be seen. It's intangible. Okay? You can only experience the service. And you cannot own any service. Okay? You just have to enjoy it. That's all. Right? And I have one more definition here. According to Philip Kotler, any act or performance that one party offers to another that is essentially intangible and does not result in ownership of anything. Its production may or may not be tied to a physical product. See, I told you when you order something in through online and Amazon person come and serves you, that is tied to physical product. But a service can be something which is not tied to physical product as well. Okay, so that is service. So now let's understand the concept of services. So the first one is, most of the service product cannot be inventoried. Inventoried means you cannot store the services, most of them. Okay, there are very few services which can be stored. Example, accommodations, monetary instruments, and your food. Okay. And the second concept is, intangible elements usually dominate value creation. Many services include important physical elements such as spare parts installed during repairs, band cards, checkbooks, hotel beds, like this. Okay. And however, it is often it is intangible elements such as processes and internet-based services which you all have experienced. And also sometimes the attitude of the people who provide service, okay, that create the most value in their service performances. So if I have my own shop and if you visit my shop and I talk to you very nicely and you like my behavior, so every time you feel like coming to my shop, right? So that's the point. And the next concept is, services are often difficult to visualize and understand. Guys, for first time customers, it is very difficult for them to understand and visualize the service because their mental intangibility is most likely to present a problem because they are not sure of it. It is first time for them, right? So this is one of the concept. And Frequent users have the advantage of past experiences that can serve as a benchmark for them. You know, you visit a five-star hotel and you know how people there behave and how they act. You visit a local restaurant and the people, how they behave or talk to you is different, right? Only if you have experienced it before, you would understand. Otherwise, it's the first time for you. It's something difficult for you. And the next concept is customers may be involved in co-production. See guys, a few services require customers to participate actively in co-producing the service product. I'll give you one example. You go to a saloon. You should tell the person, whoever is assisting you in cutting your, trimming your hair, you should give some instructions or settings to him and tell him how your hair has to be cut, right? So here even your involvement is required, right? So that's one of the concept. And the next concept is the time factor often assumes great importance. Guys, many services are delivered when the customers or you guys are there. I mean, right there to receive the services. Sometimes what happens, you will be willing to pay extra money also because you want to save some time, no? So what happens is the time matters here. Time is very important. Even though sometimes super fast trains are available, people will take flight because they want to reach early or they have some business meeting or emergency. So that's also a service concept. And the last one is distribution may take place through non-physical channels. Some service providers use electronic channels to deliver all their service elements. For this, you can take the example of banks. Nowadays, banks provide most of the services, through non-physical channels. You can withdraw money, you can, deposit money, you can also deposit the check. And you can take the mini statements or monthly statements or 6 month statements through internet banking. You can transfer funds, whatnot, right? All the banking services, most of the banking services have been done through non-physical channels nowadays. So this can be a good example for this point. So these are the concepts of services. Guys, now let's discuss the difference between goods and services. I had told you earlier. The differences are very simple. Goods are tangible, where you can see, feel and touch. But services are intangible. You cannot see or feel. You can only experience. Okay. And the second difference is ownership rights are transferable under goods. If you buy a mobile phone, you will be the owner of the mobile. Whereas transfer of ownership is not possible in service. And in product or a good, you have a uniform quality. I mean, whatever phone you buy, the quality or this from phone to phone, it will not change. Okay, for example, you buy a Redmi phone, the features and other things remains the same for you and your friend, right? But whereas to service, there is variation in quality. Suppose if you ordered for fried rice, okay. The first fried rice what I prepared was quite spicy. Maybe the second one where you had asked was little normal. It depends on the preparation. I'm just giving you an example, okay? The quality in a service may vary, okay? But in product, it is uniform. And the next difference is it can be stored for long time. The goods can be stored for long time, whereas service cannot be stored. And the next difference is selling depends on production of goods for services. See, based on how much you produce, that much you can sell. It all depends upon the demand and the supply. Whereas in services, the selling is part of service production. Suppose the Pani Puri guy has prepared to sell Pani Puris for 100 customers. He can sell only 100 customers. Over and above, he cannot because the service production is only for 100 customers. Okay, and then next difference is production and consumption is separable under goods. Production happens in a different time and consumption happens whenever the customers buy that product. Suppose I manufacture biscuits, some cookies in the month of January. I have 6 months time. So in that 6 months time, anytime a customer can buy those cookies and consume it. But in case of service, it cannot happen that way. Both the production and consumption should happen simultaneously. Okay, you order for masala dosa, you have it then. You can't have masala dosa after 6 months, right? Okay, and then goods are homogeneous and services are heterogeneous. Homogeneous here is there's a uniformed production of goods, okay? The quality, quantity depends, remains the same for each packet. Whereas in services, it's heterogeneous. The mixture comprises of two or more substances which can be distinctly observed. Okay, see, I mean to say the mixture cannot be visually differentiated, but then you can feel there is some difference. Okay, so that is service. And then next difference is goods are non-perishable, whereas services are perishable. Perishable foods are foods, for example, seafood, ripe fruits, fresh meat, etc. Whereas non-perishable items are which do not spoil or get decayed very soon. For example, sugar, your chips or some spices which you can keep for some time and then consume it, right? So goods are non-perishable and services are perishable. And the last difference of goods and services, under goods, customer has no role in production. Customer has no role at all. Only the producer or the manufacturers will produce, and then the customer will buy those goods and consume it. Whereas services, customer plays a vital role in production, right? So both the customers and the producers have to be present. So these are the differences between goods and services. So the next topic is features of services. Almost all the features we have discussed in the slide of differences. So first one is intangibility. Services cannot be seen, touched or felt. It's intangible, first feature. And the second one is perishability. You can't store a service for a long time and then consume it. Okay, it's perishable. And then third feature is inseparability. Both the customer and the service provider has to be present at the same place. So both are inseparable. And the next feature is simultaneity. Both the production and the consumption happens at the same time. So the feature of service is simultaneity. Okay, both happens at the same time. It cannot happen in two different times. And the last feature is variability. Every service is unique. It is one time generated, rendered and consumed and can never be exactly repeated at as the same point in time. See, I prepare gobi manchuri now and the same taste will not come again next time when I prepare. Okay, there might be some differences. So that's why it is variable. So guys, these are the features of services. If you have any doubts, please let me know. So the next topic is importance of services. Guys, you know, service is playing a very important role in the economy and it acts as a major source of income. So let's understand what is the importance of services. Anywhere, everywhere, now service is applicable and you know, the major part of income growth is because of service sector nowadays. So the first point here is there is an increase in demand for the services of professionally qualified technicians with establishment of technical institutes. See how IT services are making money and people have got a chance to go abroad and, you know, work in different countries. It is only because of the demand for IT sector or IT services, right? Because of good qualified technicians available in India. And the second one is communication services like entertainment, education and the right to information by the public is more important nowadays. You all, you know, use social media, you all use some entertainment programs. Nowadays, Amazon Prime, Netflix, okay, everybody has just to have some entertainment, right? So communication is also one of the important aspect of service. And, you know, education is also a very important sector and that's why there are a lot of demand for different courses in education, and education is one of the very important aspect of service. And the next one is banking services. Banking services has become so necessary that to meet financial requirements, even public or anybody, they're using banking services. Now you have different tools or machines where you can utilize the banking services. And opening an account has also become very easy for you just because of the updated technical versions of services. Right, and the next is personal care services are essential to develop potentiality of an individual, perfect personality and positive image. Sometimes what happens, you go to a saloon, you want to look good, that's why you go to a saloon, have a proper haircut, head massage. And nowadays all the different services people are able to take because of the higher income and higher purchasing capacity. And the next, obviously, electricity services are very much required for the benefit of society, industry and so on. Without electricity, can we imagine to stay happily? No, right? So one of the important aspects of services is electricity. And the next one is a very important service, hospital services. Guys, you know, hospital is very essential for the well-being of the society. A person cannot survive without the services provided by the hospital, because whenever a person falls sick, he needs some medical treatment and accommodation to stay in the hospital for the regular checkups to be done. So hospital is very important service. And nowadays, another very important services are the pager services, PCO services and worldwide web services. Now you are able to create your own blogs, you have your own YouTube channels. Many other services are provided to the customers. It is only because of the development of information technology. And obviously even this is also an important aspect of service. Every person needs leisure. Yes or no? So tourism service we should not forget. Guys, all of you want to enjoy the holiday, go to different places and, you know, experience the different food or nature or whatever is of your choice. So tourism service is also very important. So these are the importance of services. So the next topic is components of services. Under that, first one is service delivery. Guys, you all know what is service delivery. You order something and you get it through the service person is called service delivery. For example, the physical product, whatever the organization transfers to the customer, which can be touched. Okay, it is tangible and physically real. Those are service delivery components. And I can give you an example of a hotel, soap, shampoo, food, etc. And the next component is service product. Service product is the core performance purchased by the customer, the flow of events designed to provide a desired outcome. Suppose you have ordered for a service for decorating the hall for your reception. So that can be an example for your service product. And the next component is service environment. For example, if there is any restaurant near your college and that restaurant can give a signal that it is catering to the college. How? By putting the college pictures and the students' pictures on the walls. So this is a very simple example for service environment. Okay, that the restaurant is giving service to the students of the college and not for the outsiders. Okay, and the last component of service is physical product. The service product is the result of planning your work and the service delivery is the result of working your plan. Yes or no? See, for example, if you order a fast food, for example, let's say Gobi Manchuri, how much time would it take, to get ready? Maximum 10 minutes? Maximum, I'm telling. Suppose if it is taking half an hour, then the service is hindered by the person who is not paying attention in the work. Maybe he is talking to some other person without paying attention to his work, right? So physical product is a component where the service delivery is the result of working your plan. Okay. And the next topic is classification of services. This is very important as per your exam point of view, dear students. First classification is classification based on ultimate user. Under that, first one is consumer. The services which are directly provided to consumer, such as hairdressing, package, tour, dry clean, or something which is directly given to the customer, provided to the customer. Okay, that's the first classification called consumer. And the next one is business to business. See, you all know, I've discussed about this. Advertising agency, technical consultancy, accounting service, legal service, which are provided to industries. Okay, these are business to business services. And the next one is industry. This includes repairs and maintenance of plant and machinery, service installations, and service installation, maybe intercom facility like that. Okay, so these are the classifications under classification based on ultimate user. And the next classification is classification based on level of tangibility. You all know that the services are intangible, but still let's see what are the classifications under this. First one is highly tangible. See, you pay rentals for car and vending machines, you pay rentals for ATM machines, right? So these are something which is highly tangible. It's a service, but it is tangible. And then next one is services linked to tangible goods. Suppose you have got a car. Car is a product or a good. It's a machine. But servicing your car is service. You whenever it has a repair or any other problem, you give your car for service, right? So that is service. So that is called service linked to tangible goods. And the last one under this classification is highly intangible. Services like legal services, lecturing, medical service, physiotherapy, and some consultation services, all these are intangible services, actual services, I can tell you. And the next classification is classification based on customer employee presence. Under that, first one is self-service. Self-service, all of you know, right? So I can give you an example. When you go to ATM machine, you have to withdraw money by yourself, right? It's a self-service. And when you go to a restaurant, self-service restaurants, you have to collect food by yourself. Okay, that's the first classification under customer employee presence. And the second one is interpersonal service. In this type of organization, what happens, there will be presence of both customer and employee. Example, teachers and students, educational institutions, let's say only if students are there, educational institutions will be there. Only if educational institutes are there, students can come. So both have to be present, right? And the last classification under this is remote service. In this type of organization, there will be only presence of employees. The best example for this would be insurance company. Okay, so these are the classifications under customer employee presence. And the next classification is classification based on specialization or expertise. Under that, there are two classifications: professional services and non-professional services. So professional services can be medical service, legal service, accounting service, security service. Somebody has to be trained and should have some knowledge to give such services, right? So that's why it's called professional service. And even lecturing is also a professional service. And then second one is non-professional service. Maybe if you have a daycare, you need not be a professional or you need not study anything. And that would be an example. And gardening, household help, all these are non-professional services. And the next classification is classification based on service options, people-based or machine-based. Under this, people-based services are equipment-based services. So people-based are nothing but gymnasium, dental care, restaurants, tourism. Here, there should be some people to assist you. Equipment-based is nothing but ATM, coffee vending machine, telephone, cinema. All these are equipment-based services. Okay? So next classification. Classification based on profit orientation. Under this, there are two classifications, non-profit orientation and commercial or profit orientation. Under non-profit orientation, you all know Red Cross, old age homes, okay, AIDS prevention organizations, all these are, all the NGOs, I can tell you, are non-profit orientation service providers. And then the next one is commercial or profit orientation, example, brokering, real estate, consultancy services, transport and communication services. All these are profit-oriented services, okay? And the last classification under services are classification based on external internal services to manufacturers. External services are nothing but services which are concerned with installations, maintenance, computer installation, okay? All these are external services. So examples for internal services are administration, payroll, internal transport, okay? All these are internal services. And this, these are the different classifications under services. Now let's discuss the next topic, meaning and definition of services management. So you all know what is management because you are management students. Services management is a total organizational approach that makes quality of service as perceived by customer. Guys, this is the number one driving force for the operation of the business. Only when you have a good management ability, the customers will come to you only. Only when the quality is good, when the service is good, customers will come to you, right? So, services management is the total organizational approach. Let's discuss the definition. According to Grundrisse, services management is understanding the value customers receive by consuming or using the offerings of an organization and knowing how services alone or together with information, physical goods or other kinds of tangibles contribute to this value. The value is the customer's what the customers have perceived, okay, and understanding how total quality is perceived in customer relationship to facilitate such value and how it changes over time. Guys, the customer value is very important. Only if you have a good customer relationship, your services, you know, will endure for a long period of time. Yes, so that's why good management is very much required. So this is about services management. And the next topic is services marketing. Guys, you know, service is intangible and it cannot be repeated at the same type or time. But still, marketing plays a very important role for services. So, services marketing refers to the marketing of services as against tangible products. As already discussed, I have already told you, intangible services are intangible and they have to be consumed simultaneously at the time of their production. It cannot be stored, saved or resold. I can give you an example. In a restaurant, waiter service is intangible, but the food is tangible. Okay, this is about services marketing. So let's discuss the next topic, importance of marketing of services. Under that, the first point is a key differentiator. Due to increasing homogeneity in product offerings, what happens? The attendant services provided are emerging as a key differentiator in the minds of consumers. Let's say pizza. What will come to your mind? Pizza Hut, Domino's, Vanasta. I'm just giving you an example. So, how do you differentiate pizza from these service providers? Is left to the customer, right? So that's the first difference. That's the first importance. And the next importance is importance of relationships. Relationships are a key factor when it comes to marketing, right? When it comes to marketing of products or services, relationship is very, very important. Okay. So there is the need to listen to the needs of the customer and fulfill them. See, when you need a service of head massage, so you tell them why you need a head massage. Maybe your head is paining a lot that day. So you give some instructions. Based on your need, I have to give you a massage, right? So that's kind of relationship what I have to maintain so that next time you would remember me when you have a headache again. Okay. And the next importance is customer retention. Today's highly competitive scenario, there are multiple providers, right? So in this situation, to retain a customer is so, it's so very important for the service provider, right? So only when you retain, when you're able to retain the customer by providing good service and, you know, satisfying services, the customers will always prefer you, right? And the next importance is relationships are key. We have already discussed about this. Effective relationships in service marketing will lead to repeat sales and positive word of mouth. Yes or no? And the next importance is multiple touch points. Service marketing involves many touch points for the customer. Interaction with multiple people, experiences, and buying an actual product all impact the customer's perspective of the purchase process. These touch points work together to establish a perception in the consumer's mind. Okay. Suppose your friend has watched a movie and, you know, your friend is explaining you the experience of the movie. For example, the movie is too good and your friend has thoroughly enjoyed. And whatever touch points it gives about the movie is very important. Okay, please relate this with a service, right? And the next importance is services proliferate. Okay, customers have many service options to choose from. And because the product is intangible, the challenge for the service marketer is to somehow make the services stand out from the crowd. Because service marketing is prolific, marketers must think of ways to communicate the benefits of the service they offer in language that reflects the customer need and value. Otherwise, they will definitely, don't understand the importance of the service. Okay, and the next importance is feedback improves service. I have been telling you in Pizza Hut, if at all you like the service, they ask you to ring the bell. That's the feedback whatever you give. Feedback is really very important and it definitely improves the service, guys. So this is one of the important aspects of the services. And the last importance is technology impacts. Technology is having a major impact on the service economy. You can use technology to streamline service activities and provide do-it-yourself option for consumers. Example, if you want to go somewhere, you can book Ola. If you Ola through an app, and that is through technology, right? If you want to make a video call, you use your application, and mobile is also a technology. If you want to, nowadays online classes have become very famous, right? All those are because of technology, and we are able to provide services through technology. So these are the importance. So now let's discuss the nature of service marketing. Nature and role of service marketing is important. First, let's discuss the nature of services marketing. It's a dynamic process. Obviously, service providers should be full of energy and enthusiastic, right? And then it is customer-oriented, obviously. And it is creative. They have to be creative to attract the customers. And it is intangible. You can't see it. Transfer of ownership is not possible. All these are features of services. It is heterogeneous. And it has zero shelf life. That means you can't store anything. Cannot be inventory. Services and production is inseparable. As I told you, both the customer and the manufacturer or the producer have to be at the same place to enjoy the service. I mean, the production and the consumption happen at the same time, I meant. And then it is perishable and it is a social process. Social process here is it, I mean, there is an interaction. Alone, services cannot happen. And it's a economic function. Obviously, it's an economic function. There's huge profits because of services. And the last one is it involves customer participation. As I told you, services cannot happen by itself. There should be some interaction. Even if you're doing with a machine, you have to interact, and machine also should interact back to you, right? So these are the nature of service marketing. Now let's discuss the role of service marketing. The first point is reduced operating expenses. So here the operating expenses are quite very less because production and consumption happen simultaneously. And that there is competitive differentiation. Example, if masala dosa is, if there are two restaurants side by side, whoever gives you the best one, you would go there, right? And then enhanced efficiency. Obviously, through service marketing, the efficiency is enhanced. Because only if you are a good service provider, able to give the quality product at a minimum time period to a customer, your efficiency is obviously enhanced. And the quality is also enhanced because there are too many competitors. And there is enhanced responsiveness. See, near the college only you see there are different people who sell sandwiches or example Maggie. But you go to a particular place because he is able to give you a good quality product at a reasonable price and the time limit. Yes, and that's why there is more response over there. Enhanced market share. So wherever there are more response, more customers, there are more profits. Okay. And then enhance customer loyalty. As I told you, whichever shop you like more, you go there more. So you become a loyal customer to that shop. And then enhanced competition. The competition is also enhanced because there are two or more service providers. But you, when there are more people to one particular service provider or shop, then obviously his competition, he's able to compete with the other one. And the manufacturing support is very much required for the services marketing. Why? Because only when suppose you want to make a sandwich, you need a sandwich maker, right? So providing it is a service, but then manufacturing support should always be there for the service. And the last one is makes economic sense. Obviously, any service makes economic sense. It is not at all a waste. There is huge profits, you know, based on services. So these are the role of service marketing. So now comes a very important topic. 7 P's of services marketing. You guys have already studied the marketing mix of products. Very 4 important P's. Here it is 7 P's. Okay. I will not stress further. Please listen. First one is product. In services marketing mix, product refers to services offered. Okay. Though service products are essentially intangible, there are certain physical characteristics which customers will assess in their evaluation of the service product choice. Maybe it includes some, how do you attract the customers based on the accommodation you provide, or some tourist packages. These are some examples. Okay. And then, and guys, next one is pricing. Pricing is an important element of the marketing mix. Okay. Because only with pricing, you can able to get some revenues and profits. The success of service depends on the pricing strategy, which is developed or adopted by the company. So how do you price the services is very, very important. And the next one is promotion. Services marketing can retain existing customers, attract new customers, increase brand awareness, build business, and can also reduce their perceived risk and gain the trust of the customers through promotional campaigns. Promotion is very important for services. And the 4th element is place. Place involves various efforts made by the service organization to make the services accessible and available to the customers. Guys, service location plays an important role in the service delivery. Yes or no? See, most of you would like to eat in the proper restaurants, and very few prefer to eat roadside. So based on your mentality, so location or the place again plays a very important role. And the next element is people. This element of service marketing mix is very important because almost all the services are delivered by one human being to another. The person delivering the service creates customer satisfaction, and the perception of the service depends on their interaction. So people is one of the very important element of services marketing. And the next element is physical evidence. Customers in the service sector attempt to take cues about the service provider's capabilities and also the quality of service offered from physical evidence. Suppose you go to a movie and you see the ratings given and the percentage given in the apps, and then you go. That acts as a physical evidence, right? So physical evidence is very important. And the last element under services marketing is process. Process is an important element again for the marketing mix that determines how a service should be created and delivered to the customer. I mean to say the standard procedure or the format. You go to McDonald's anywhere in Bangalore, the way they greet and the prices and how they serve the customers are same. Okay, so that's the process. I mean to say the standard procedure. So these are the 7 P's of services marketing. If you have any doubts, please let me know. So now let's discuss the last topic of this chapter, reasons for the growth of services in India. First one is economic affluence. One of the key factors for the growth of demand for services is the economic affluence. In rural households, the upper income category is growing at a faster rate, guys, than the urban households. Because of this, the economic liberalization process has a positive impact on the Indian households. So the economic level or the income as well as their expenditure has been pushed, creating a demand for many goods and services. Everybody, nobody thinks to buy nowadays, right? So everybody wants to enjoy their life. They don't, only they, the matter is with regard to the quality. Right? So economic affluence is the first reason for the growth of services. And the next reason is changing role of women. Traditionally, Indian women were never used to work. Okay, they were all confined to household activities and staying at home. And women are now are allowed to work. They're able to, you know, purchase whatever they want. So even they are also employed in different services, police services, postal services, hospital services, whatnot. All the services, they are there. And obviously, the growth of services has been increased. And the next reason is cultural changes. Change is the underlying philosophy of culture, but place of change in Indian culture is not uniform. Now, everybody have a small family, right? So, everybody wants services like entertainment, telecommunication, transport, education, tourism. All of them are interested in all these services and their purchasing capacity, income capacity has also been increased. So, that has led to the growth of services. And the next reason is IT revolution. For the last 15 years, India is occupying a vital position in the area of information technology. IT has become one of the key service businesses of the country. Yes or no, guys? See, Bangalore itself has become the IT hub. So you can see people from various states and sometimes even from different countries who are coming for here for work, and some people are here for even for the education, right? So because of this IT, there is huge growth in the area of services. And the next one is development of markets. See, during the last few decades, the wholesaler and the retail population has grown in the country. Okay. The retailing has spread to the nooks and corners of the street, and in the rural areas, retail business is significantly present. And because of these developments, there are high demand for the services. And the next reason is market orientation. The changing competitive situation and demand supply position, this has forced a manufacturing organization to shift their philosophy from production orientation to market orientation. Everybody are more interested in marketing. See, if you have a very good product, but your marketing strategy or the promotional strategy is very weak, so obviously your product would fail in the market. So marketing or market orientation has become very important, and because of market orientation, the services has gained a lot of importance and there is too much of growth. For example, see accounting services, auditing services, HR services, you can see many consultation services nowadays, right? This is only because of market orientation. And the next reason is healthcare consciousness. Nowadays, you see too many people are into gymnastics, yoga, and many other health related activities like aerobics and Zumba classes, many others. Because in India, the healthcare market has grown substantially. The increased life expectancy is the result of the consciousness of the people regarding the health issues. Nowadays, people are very, very health conscious, and definitely this has led to the growth of services in India.
And the next reason is economic liberalization. Guys, because of this liberalization with the disinvestment and privatization policies, there are different offers and facilities available to the customers. Let's take an example of banking, insurance, telecommunication, hospitality, health service, entertainment. Each sectors, whatever examples I gave, they have a different ways of promoting their service. Let's take entertainment. If you book your tickets through online or Book My Show, you will get some discount. Let's say food, you get discounts when you order online than when you go there to have. Yes or no? And that's why economic liberalization has led for the growth of service. And the next one is rampant migration. You know, rural people are coming to urban and semi-urban areas for the want of jobs. Only because of this, there is expansion of cities and townships, due to which businesses like real estates, transportation, infrastructure services, they are increasing, you know, at a very rapid state. And all these are services oriented, and that's why there's a lot of growth in this. And the next reason is export potential. India is considered to be a potential source for services. Guys, there are a number of services that India offers to various parts of the world. Example, banking, insurance, transportation, data services, accounting services, entertainment, education, health services, like this. There are many services, you know, which are exported. And that's why this has led to the growth of services. And the last one is service tax. The growth in the service sector attracted the attention of the government as a tax generating source. Over the years, what happened, the number of services brought under service tax has increased to a very higher rate. So the service tax is levied on hotels and restaurants, storage, transportation and communications, real estates, and many other personal services also. Okay, so these are the reasons for the growth of services in India, and these are this question is quite important for the exam. If you have any doubts with regard to any topic, please feel free to contact me. Thank you for watching, guys. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.